Oh, Thanksgiving Day. Look at that food. Oh, and then the family gatherings. That can be like a minefield for some of you. And we've got family counselor, Dr. Rachel Glick. She says this time of year, her clients ask, what should I do about my dot, dot, dot? Dr. Glick joins us to fill in those dots with some solutions so you don't have to step on those minefield explosive topics. Mm-hmm. All right, what are the two key aspects to handling a strained relationship?
First of all is focusing on your own self-care first. When you come from a place of feeling more grounded with yourself, then you're able to handle whatever is going on in the relationship from a much better place.
So I got to handle everything before I go inside there.
Well, we want to really learn, the key is we tend to give power to people that we have problems with or some strain with, but the more that we take charge by really working on ourselves, then that really brings the power back to
us. Then we're living our lives for ourselves and not for somebody else. And so then you got to deal with the relationship. So some of the things you've heard this week, and I thought these were interesting. What should I do about mother who constantly criticizes and guilts me for not being closer? Brother who shows neither warmth nor accountability for his behavior? Marriage that is so rocky we can hardly be in the same room together? Sister who drinks and is obviously favored by my alcoholic father? Mother-in-law who takes way too much control in our own home? These are all real issues.
Exactly. Yeah, and one of the most important things that I like to keep in mind is that you're not alone. We all have issues where there's a strain or something pushes our buttons, and that it really helps for us to be self-aware and know what it is that's being triggered inside of us.
And so when you say know your heart, that's what you're talking
about. Know your heart, exactly. And then from there, it gives us a chance to be able to learn the lessons that we're here to learn. Even if the messenger's wrong, we want to take the message and really use it for our own growth.
So is that the self-compassion that you have to practice for yourself?
And that's a common one that most of us have to learn for ourselves. First of all, we're not alone in this. Everybody has issues in their families or with people. It's how we grow. But also that being kind to ourselves and not taking ourselves too seriously, laughing at ourselves in some of the aspects of our life.
And get to know what a parent of a two-year-old knows so well. Learn to say no.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, no is one of my favorite spiritual words, learning how to set boundaries so that you can be more loving, really.
And then extract some of these life lessons and make it a part of your life. Mm-hmm. Increase your resourcing. What's that mean? That which lights your fire and grounds you?
Yes. So I have a list actually attached to my blog. There are things that help you feel grounded. It could be in nature. It could be with people, with animals, creativity, things you do with your mind. And so we have a lot more that we can do that we take charge of feeling centered and grounded and inspired and enlivened. And then when we come from that place of more full, then we're much less in a taking mode or vulnerable to the things that are going on around us with other people.
And if you're so verklempt and you just say, I can't make it, I'm just going to call
That's
in
right.
sick. Hey, I can't go. Yeah. I'm not feeling well.
That's right. Sometimes we need to take a pass.
Yeah.
And just be connected to our truth and that we're not there yet. Be able to deal with it in a way that we feel good about.
All right, well, check out the blog. Once again, where is it located?
It's on my website.
There you go. And we'll link you there on our website at fox2now.com. Dr. Rachel Glick, thanks so much for coming.
My pleasure.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Same to you.
Yeah, we're going to take a little break. We'll be back with more Fox 2 News in the morning with all the giblets and dressing right after this.